Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the podcast. I'm Angel True and Love. Yes, I apologize again last week. No Rampage review last week, but back here for it again. Although I did have my Dynamite review up for Thursday, so if you didn't check that out, you can go ahead. But I went and missed 2 weeks in a row, so here we go, back in on the podcast. Rampage, you know, solid performance. Obviously, the big headline, Hook. Hook made his debut tonight against Fuego del Sol, and he impressed. He impressed. I barely wrote anything down just because his first match, and he looked great in that match for his debut match. And of course, Fuego del Sol is a very formidable opponent for your first match, but he definitely shined. And with Dad on commentary, Taz on commentary, I'm sure it had to be a great moment for him as well. All in all, good. We, of course, also had Lucha Brothers vs. FTR, which is a good match. Of course, we were supposed to have it last week, but due to travel restrictions for Phoenix, it was Penta and Pac versus FTR. Still got a good match between the two. Not exactly what I bet was going to happen last week. Still a good outing. Got a match added to Winter's Coming as well. As well as a solid finish between Adam Cole and Wheeler Yuta. But to start the show, getting into review here, Lucha Brothers vs. FTR open Rampage tonight. So a match between two. I mean, you know, FTR, looking back at it, you're just happy for them, seeing them in these type of feuds against these caliber attack teams, especially how they were a couple years ago. It's just a really good scene. But here again with against the Lucha Brothers, you know, I think it could have been better. You know, I don't think it wasn't as good as their match at Full Gear right off the bat. And I think that with it supposed to be 2 out of 3 falls last week, I think it definitely would have been better than what we got here tonight. But still a good match. I just think probably, because I have a feeling as well, that it could have been better. Could have been better. But so, still Dalton Gonzalez doing the ring announcing. You know, hope Justin Roberts, whatever is with him, hope thoughts and prayers out with him. Hope he gets better because we miss him. Although Dasha does a good job as well with the announcing. But early in the match, Dax laid out Phoenix with a backdrop on the apron. The first part of this match was attacked by on Phoenix throughout the match. And then finally, it was a springboard from the one of the many acrobats of Phoenix. Springboard from the outside, back in. Hurricanrana off the top rope to Dax for separation. Got back from break, got the hot tag to his brother Penta. And he ran wild, hit Sling Blade on Dax and Cash. Cash did counter for a near fall or try to sweep up for a steal of a pin. And then I think Cash was going for a body slam or whichever, but Phoenix, or excuse me, Penta counted for a two count. Hit Main Japan for another near fall. Phoenix was flying in on offense after a tag. He was on the apron, but totally got in his face. And Taz said, respect your elders. Well, Phoenix didn't listen, and he decked Tully anyways. Took him out for time being. Back in the ring, Dax hit beautiful, although it was tricky. A rebound powerbomb to Phoenix off the ropes for a two count. And then miscommunication. So the spot that almost won the match at Full Gear, Cash tried to hit Phoenix in the face with one of the AAA title belts, but Phoenix and the referee caught it. So then the referee goes down accidentally, and Dax in the ring incidentally gets hit in the face by the title belt by Phoenix. And Phoenix is like, oh well, he'll take it. And then little homage to Eddie Guerrero. Anyone goes for a frog splash, but he's too far, so he hits his tightrope kick, which I still know how he does, on the top rope to Cash. Went for a frog splash to Dax, but Dax got the belt up, hit Phoenix in the face, and went to cover only for a two count. And then Phoenix ran wild. He went off the top rope. It also looked like, well, FTR hit the big rig, but it looked like someone was late. But still, a big rig for a near fall. And then finally, to win the match, Lucha Brothers hit the Fear Factor. Phoenix hit a suicida on the outside, taking out the other member of TR. 1, 2, 3. Lucha Brothers retain, and they get the victory, which I'm sure will rest this feud. It was a nice feud between two of the best tag teams, but I think, you know, with now that Phoenix and Penta have gotten a little bit of time with the titles, now presumably ending this feud with FTR with this match here, maybe we start to see Santana Ortiz in the fold, because we have not seen them in quite a bit. But we'll see. But good match. And Lucha Brothers retain. Definitely the low spot of the show. We got Ty Conti, Anna Jay, and Ruby Soho. First, Nyla Rose, The Bunny, and Penelope Ford. Trios match for the women. You know, this was obviously to build up Ruby Soho and Nyla Rose for their eventual match in the semifinals of TBS title tournament. But this was okay, I would say. Because, I mean, we know Ruby, Nyla, and Conti are good. Anna Jay's still very young. She's improving. The Bunny and Penelope Ford are not really good. But nonetheless, so The Bunny got the brass knuckles. She laid out Anna Jay while the referee was distracted. And Nyla Rose hit the Beast Bomb on Anna Jay for the win. Nyla Rose and her crew get the win. I mean, only signifying, it seems, that it's going to be Ruby Soho going over and Nyla Rose, or over Nyla Rose, which would be the right outcome, obviously. So then we got Darby Allin and Sting. They were backstage. They got ambushed by FTR, who, and Tully Blanchard. And they were talking about Greensboro going there in 2 weeks, making their debut for AEW. I'm curious if they do a tag team match here with FTR, Darby Allin, Sting. And Greensboro. Perhaps this was a little setup, you know. They did the match for Grand Slam, so I mean, who knows, but eh. You know, you kind of wish Darby Allin, he had the match of the year versus MJF at Full Gear. And he's kind of not really been, no offense to FTR, but I mean, hopefully he's in a feud of importance. We'll see. So then we got the highlight of Rampage. Hook. Taz's son, Hook, makes his debut for Team Taz. You know, the hype's been out there. You know, we've seen him out with Team Taz a lot, but he has not gotten the ring. And it happened tonight, and although his hair took me by surprise, I'm not really sure what was up with his hair. I'm sure if Chris Jericho was there, he would have said something, but odd hairdo nonetheless. Hook this match with Fuego del Sol. I think very good showcase. Very good. You know, Hook and his father Taz documented it throughout the match. Him having backgrounds in judo and jiu-jitsu, you know, held himself well. You know, he had some jewel throws, hip toss, you know, controlled the mat well for Fuego. You know, he looked more like a boxer with his attire than a wrestler. That's my take, but I mean, it's probably designed that way, but nonetheless, did a very good job, and he did almost a variation of his father's Taz mission. He walked in the legs, he had a head arm choke, and Fuego tapped. Hook. I like his theme music as well, so there's that. But, you know, back on Dynamite, you know, they've mentioned before about the pillars and the four pillars, you know, MJF has said him, Darby Allin, Sammy Guevara, and Jungle Boy. Well, Hook, very young, you could add him along with Daniel Garcia to the pillars of AEW. That's my take, but you know, well, not much be said, just very good debut by Hook. We had a match added to Winter's Coming Wednesday. We got Matt Sydal versus Wardlow. So MJF and Wardlow on the same card. I'm curious. You know, the MJF Dante Martin match is much interesting because, you know, I mean, we know that MJF is feuding with CM Punk. Question is, will MJF win the Dynamite Diamond Ring for a third year in a row? Would CM Punk costs MJF? Could we see, because MJF eliminated Wardlow in the Battle Royal last week, or on Wednesday, excuse me. Could we see potentially, because they're layering more teases for the breakup between MJF and Wardlow. Could we see potentially MJF be cost the Dynamite Diamond Ring accidentally by Wardlow? I don't know, but some intriguing outcomes. Now the main event. Adam Cole versus Wheeler Yuta. Fine match, we know. In a way, this felt like a lumberjack match with how much people were at ringside, but still a good match. You know, Adam Cole, he was out there with the Young Bucks, Cutler, and Fish. Yuta, he was out with the best friends, so Rocky Romero. Again, good to see Trent back. But, you know, Willie Yuta is still relatively young to AEW, and he is able to work with some of the big stars, and he's improving under tutelage of the best friends. So, late in the match, Cole went for Panama Sunrise, but Yuta countered for a near fall. Yuta followed up with a crossbody, fought with a... I'm not sure if he what he was going for, probably a diving lariat. Anyways, he hit his elbow for a two count. Cole and Yuta were exchanging, but Yuta hit a German suplex for a two count. Yuta then went for a top rope slash, but Cole got the knees up, and then Cole hit a super kick, and then not once but twice locked eyes with Orange Cassidy. And before he hit the boom to the back of the head of Yuta, he motioned to Orange Cassidy. Again, a match that's going to be happening in the future. Cole hit the boom, the Shining Wizard to the back of the head. 1, 2, 3. Adam Cole gets the victory over Willer Yuta. After a match, the best friends came to the aid of Yuta, but eventually Adam Cole super click got the advantage of the best friends, attacked him after the bell. Adam Cole and the Bucks hit a BT trigger on the returning Trent. And that was how thing went off the air. You know, with chaos being aligned again with Adam Cole, I imagine, because we're going to get it, they're teasing it. We're going to get Adam Cole versus Orange Cassidy, and then perhaps, you know, because they're going to have Okada come in for a big name. And with Okada, Chaos, potentially when Adam Cole is done with Orange Cassidy, Okada comes in, takes that role, and we potentially get Okada versus Adam Cole. Good possibility, of course. We have to see, but that would be a good possibility. Because we know Okada is coming in for a big name. And Cole is one of the biggest names out there. And with this feud going on, we'll see. But would be a good opportunity. But nonetheless, that's the review for you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, I apologize for not having the review up net last week. But it's good being back this week for the review. Of course, I'll be back for reviews next week. Winter's coming. and then Rampage after that. Also, I have to figure out because Rampage in 2 weeks will be on Christmas Day, which is Saturday. And most of the NFL football is on Sunday, the day after. So I'll have to figure out when I can do a review then. Particularly Monday is the day I'm targeting, but we'll see. I'll figure it out, but nonetheless, that hope you guys enjoy this video. I am Adriel Chonla. See you guys back next week. Be safe. Peace.